Today, Joe and I are fossil hunting in Florida at a location we haven't been to in years. The hope is that recent high water will have eroded some new fossils for us to find. We found some pretty good stuff here in the past, and we're just hoping that we get lucky today. There might be something cool in this little bin. Only way we'll find out is by getting in there. Oh, I see that little right oop there. Joe needs to fix his wetsuit. Joe's been underwater for just a couple of seconds, and he says he's already got something. So he's gonna toss it up at me, and we'll see what it is. So here's that bone that Joe tossed at me. It seems to be a really well mineralized and preserved ankle bone to either an extinct camel, llama, horse. We're not sure, we don't have enough bones to tell, but that is awesome. It is an extinct ankle bone to a large grazing mammal.
Joe, I don't mean to scare you, but there is a gator slide over here, so I don't know if you want to get out or not, and he's getting out.
Yeah, that's one of the things that we're looking out for when we come to the river, is we got to see if there's gator slides. And that is definitely a classic slide. You can see where the sand is smooth, so a gator is going in the creek right here. And even though there was definitely bone in there and we could find something good, it is not worth the risk. So we're going to keep moving further down creek and hope to find something else where there's not a big lizard.
Can I walk now?
Yeah, your hair is good, bro.
Do I walk now?
Yeah, you can walk now.
You can't put this on there now.
Joe! So Joe over here is being a little scaredy cat. So he's making me do all of the fordings first. But this is what we have to do to be able to hike through these woods and find stuff. But so far, so good. You really can't tell how deep at all it is right now. We know over there it's about 8 feet deep. Right here is only a couple.
Oh, that's not that bad.
That wasn't that bad. It's about to be river monster time. That's a piece of a giant armadillo scoot. That's tortoise shell. There are fossils in here. Unfortunately, this spot has been mostly sanded over. Just some turtle shell and not a lot of really good fossils, so we gotta keep moving. I do not see any gator slides. But don't die, I like you too much. Ooh, that's a little bit deep.
It's a little bit deep, yeah.
You made it?
I think so.
Alright, I'm coming. Now, how many of you would be willing to do this in Florida rivers just for a few rocks? Joe and I are. I don't know about you guys, but it is totally worth it to be fossil hunting out here. And I was getting hot anyway, so why not take a swim? We found a nice bend in the river, but it's pretty dark and it looks pretty deep. So Joe and I are looking around right now.
It's normally above my head, and it's 2 feet higher than it is then.
And we do want to find stuff, but we don't want to mess with gators. There's a gator in the water swimming on top of the surface. And, oh no, he just went down. That was definitely a bigger gator.
Oh yeah, look at the size of this boy.
Look at the slides up here. We're looking at the slide right in front of Joe. I'm gonna see if he surfaces again, but I think he heard us.
How are we gonna get across here?
Makes you nervous, doesn't it?
No. Yeah, it makes you very nervous. You could be dragged under and fetched up under a log and marinated for a month and then slowly eaten by a 60 million year old, heavily evolved reptilian killing machine that you don't actually have to be that afraid of, because they're not evil. They're just predictable.
When we tell you guys we go to some wild places, this is what we mean. This is wild Florida.
This sucks.
So this is kind of interesting right now. We're actually walking along the flood boundary to the creek. So during flood season, this will get up 14 feet higher than it is right now. And these ponds represent the boundary to the river during those high staging events. So Joe and I were originally thinking this was a game trail where all this stuff has been pushed down, but actually a single gator has done that. You can see right here the tail slide, and then that right there is where the hand, the paw of this gator was. So that is actually bigger than my hand, which would put that at what? A 10-foot gator?
Big gator.
Real big gator. So we're gonna cut through all these palm fronds and get back to the river because we do not want to be hanging out here. That is, yeah, that's huge. That's a big animal. So we might be a little spooked right now, but after all that, we do need to get back in the water because we did come here to find fossils, and that's what I still plan to do. There's stuff out here. Here's a better look at that partial mammoth tooth we just found. So mammoths were grazers, and you can see they had these enamel plates right here for grinding down hundreds of pounds of grass every single day. So that's a cool find. I wish it was whole, but Joe's over here diving, and hopefully he'll find something cool in just a minute. That'd be really sweet. Ooh, that's a mean looking snaggle tooth. Ovations.
A deer antler.
Oh, you got deer antler as well?
Yep. A lot more down there, maybe.
This is a good spot, Joe.
Mm-hmm.
Go, 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 dive, dive. That's pretty cool, Joe.
Yeah, invert nuts will like that.
Yeah, the invert guys. Oh, look at even the fossilized barnacles on the back.
Yeah, I'll try and keep that, but they usually fall apart.
I know, it's a really awesome scallop. It's pretty. All right, guys, there we go. Another set of gator slides. That's its tail going back and forth. And then big old claw footprints, tail going back more and more, and then he dumped in, or she dumped in the river right there. And I've actually run into this gator before in that bend over there, and it is not a small animal. So today's been kind of really slow. Lots of gators, not as many fossils as we hoped, but we've got one more spot today and then we're going home. We're getting out here. We're gonna come back here when it's lower and not so scary.
When the gators go home.
It's about time for the last spot of today, and hopefully we get a trip maker from here. Only one way to find out. Have to get back underwater. All right, guys, so this is ivory, and I think I have the very tip to a tusk down there, which is pretty cool. So let's go see if that's true. I wish this had been whole, but the rivers and creeks are just not kind for this kind of thing. So let's check it and see if what it is. That is. That's cool. Yeah, you guys don't know how long I've been waiting for this moment. I was talking to Joe about this earlier, but a couple of years ago I found the front section to a big mastodon tooth with a tooth that goes out in front of it, and I've always wanted to find the missing part of it, and right behind me in this hole is that missing part. So all those gators, all that hard work today is absolutely so, Joe's over there shaking his head, but it's so worth it. I'm gonna grab it, I'll show it to you guys, and we'll get home. We'll put this tooth together for the first time in I don't know how many years, and that's really cool. Today, that, I don't know,
Blah, 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 grab the tooth.
I'll grab the tooth, Joe. It's hot and there's been a lot of gators, but it's been worth it.
Here we go.
Yep, that's gotta be the missing piece.
That's incredible. I had written this part of this tooth off. It is so rare to find the missing tooth to one of these. I thought it'd either be buried somewhere over here, underneath the bank here, or it had already blasted into a million pieces. So I'm gonna check this out one quick time to make sure there's not any more of this animal here, and then we're gonna hike all the way home, keep avoiding those gators, and I'll put those two parts of the tooth together. And ooh, that just bit me. Is it a dolphin fly larvae?
Ouch.
Look at that. There's a lot of crazy stuff in Florida. Like we said, everything's here trying to kill you.
Some giant tortoise shell. That's still a good find. Another awesome extinct animal that used to be here. Catch.
We just wrapped up the last bend of today, and the best thing that we found today was this section of a mastodon tooth. Not only are mastodon teeth rare in general, but we actually have the missing section to this tooth, and I cannot wait to go home, click that together, and share it with you guys. Right in front of it, we did manage to find these two sections of giant tortoise shell. We find a lot of these in Florida because they have a large preservation bias towards them due to the fact that they're so thick and solid already. So these guys were as large, if not larger, than the Galapagos Island tortoises, and are a really cool reminder of the extinct reptiles that used to be here in Florida. Besides them, we did find some tusk material to this mastodon. We've got these two pieces right here. You can see the growth lines in this one, and then this is the very tip of the tusk. Unfortunately, these guys are made out of ivory, and they get blasted by even the smallest creeks, so it's very rare to find a whole one. Last but not least, we have this ear bone. So this is a porpoise ear bone, which is really rare, and most people overlook them, but that's probably a unique extinct species, but there is no way to tell from what. But that's still cool to us. We are both exhausted now, and we have a long hike out of here. As soon as we get home, we'll click that tooth together and show it to you guys. All right, guys, we are out of the woods, and I'm going to be completely honest with you. We should have never found this. This is the remaining piece to a tooth that we found over 3 years ago in this same creek. During that day, Joe actually found his best mastodon tooth that he ever recovered. And I was, to be honest, pretty jealous, so I spent the rest of the day trying to top that. And during that process, I managed to recover this tooth. Now, this is actually two teeth. They join together right here, and you can see where the pressure of this tooth coming in wore out this tooth right here. I spent all day trying to find the remaining portion to this tooth right here, and I could not find it. Joe and I have been back to this creek a dozen times, and we have never found the remaining portion. I actually wrote it off. I never thought we would find it. I thought it was either busted, it was buried somewhere where it's never gonna erode out, and it just was never gonna happen. But I kept checking this spot every single year after every single high rain, and thankfully, today, a little fossil hunting miracle occurred, and we were able to put together this tooth after, I have no idea how long, but I can't imagine how long they've been separated. And this is actually, it's a very large example of a mastodon tooth. This is an M3. It's the last molar this animal would have gotten before it died. And if you notice, we've got a really cool thing going on with the coloration of the enamel. So this is the actual color of this mastodon's enamel, but most teeth you find in these creeks, especially if they're tannin rich, they've got dissolved organics like leaves, they get stained this black coloration. So this part we found in the clay 3 years ago, and this part was stuck in the river channel itself, getting stained by those river tannins. And so when you put them together, you've got that kind of that discoloration going on. You don't have a balance. And I actually really like that. It tells a story from today. And this tooth is going to be in my collection for a very long time. It's really incredible that we were managed to connect and save this history after all these years. Now, for those of you who have been following the channel for a while, we are going to be doing something really special. We are giving away this mastodon tooth. This is an authentic, extinct American mastodon molar found in the Midwest of the United States. And all you guys have to do to enter to win it is go to diggingscience.com/newsletter, which is linked in the description below. Once you enter to get our newsletter, you're going to be automatically entered into the drawing for this tooth. We're going to be updating you guys on who wins it in the comments below, as well as in our community tab. And I cannot wait to give this tooth to one of you guys. We really appreciate each one of you guys so much. And without you, we would not have built this channel into what it is. So stay tuned for future updates, guys. And as always, keep on digging science.